In this video, we'll be learning different layouts in Android. This video is a continuation of the previous video. So if you haven't checked it, go and check the playlist for Android development course. The link will be provided in the description. Now, open the project and go to activity-main.xml. You can find it inside app, res, layout and activity-main.xml file. Now open it and go to the design part. We will be talking about two types of layout, linear layout and constraint layout in this video. First of all, let's see what is linear layout. Go to layouts in the palette and you can see their constraint layout and linear layout. Linear layout has two orientations, vertical and horizontal. So let's remove what we have done previously. Select them and click delete. Now we have to change the layout. By default, it is kept as constraint layout. Now go to the split mode. And change the constraint layout to linear layout. And we have to open it here. So just now let's implement linear layout with some text views inside. Now what linear layout does is it arranges the views inside the layout either vertically or horizontally. So let's check it. Now I'll be adding some text views inside the linear layout and showing you the demos. So add three text views. Now I have added three text views inside a linear layout. Now by default, if you haven't told any orientation, it is showing horizontal orientation. Now we can change it by adding the orientation to vertical. Now you can see that the text views are aligned vertically. Now just change it to horizontal. You can see they are horizontally aligned. Now basically what this does is it arranges the views inside the layout either horizontally or vertically. Now linear layout is a very useful layout in Android development and you'll be using it a lot. So make sure you understand it. Now let's take a look at constraint layout. Remove the text views and change the layout to constraint layout and also remove the orientation. Now constraint layout is used when you have to create more complex UIs. If you have to design a very complex user interface, you can use constraint layout. It works with constraints. If you add a text view, it needs constraints to know where to place this text view in the layout. So let's add a text view and see. Go to the design and just drag and drop a text view to anywhere you'd like it to be kept. If you want it to be here, you have to add constraints to this text view. So place the text view where you have to see it, then go to the attributes on the right side. You can see the attributes and inside that you have to go to the constraint widget. If you click on the left constraint, it will add a constraint to the left. And if you click on the right, it will add a constraint to the right. Now, if you want to keep this text view on the sender horizontally, then you have to change the constraint of both left and right to 0. And place it on the exact sender. Now you can see it is placed exactly sender. Then if you have to keep it vertically in the sender, you can either use the constraint widget or you can go to the design and click on the round symbol and drag it to the top. You can see that it's constrained to the top, and also click on the down symbol, round symbol, and drag it to the bottom. Now you can see it is constrained to stay in the sender. You can see the constraints. Now this is how constraint layout works. If you want to add another text view or button just above the text view, place it and add constraints. You can use the constraint widget or just drag and drop within the design. You can see the button is also constrained. Now let's add some more views to the layout and see. Let's add an image view. Now you have to set the width and the height of the image. And just drag and drop it to a place you have to keep it. And give the constraints. Now you can see the constraints are also given. Now you can adjust it by dragging it, okay. What happens in the behind when we do this is, go to the split mode. You can see that it's constrained with start to start of and end of parent, like that. This is how we can design a complex view using constraint layout. You could actually create a very complex layout with this. Hope you understand this video. If you have any doubts, leave comments and I will definitely be replying it. Subscribe to this channel for more such videos and give it a thumbs up if you like this video.